Welcome to another class of EDT 830. This is the fourth topic, and we are going to examine script writing and storyboarding. In this class, we are going to look at the relationship between the two concepts and examine the stages you need to follow as you are coming up with your script for multimedia production. So, let's go to class. Remember in our last video, I explained that there are three phases of multimedia production: pre-production phase, production phase, and post-production phase. At the pre-production phase, you have scripting and storyboarding as critical components of multimedia production. So we are going to look at scripting and storyboarding in this topic, look at the differences and how you can be able to write effective scripts for your multimedia production, whether you are doing an instructional video or an audio content for your students. And by the end of this lesson, I expect you to be able to differentiate between scripting and storyboarding, although many people use the two words interchangeably, but at this level of your education, you should be able to differentiate between scripting and storyboarding. Then you should be able to analyze stages in script writing and evaluate the script for multimedia production. Now let's start this way. Let's first examine the concept of script writing. You either call it script writing or scripting, is the same thing. Now, similar to preparing a presentation, scripting allows you to properly organize your thoughts, determine exactly what you want to convey to your students, and how you want to present your information to the students in the classroom. This might be done by typing the contents in Microsoft Word or Notepad, or even by writing the contents on a sheet of paper. You might just scribe something. It might not be a formal scripting per se, but you need to scribe something somewhere that will guide you when you are recording your video, for instance, or when you are recording your audio content. Whichever approach you adopt, either manual or electronic means — manual means that you just write on a sheet of paper, or electronic means by typing on Microsoft Word or Notepad — basically, scripting is a Word document that outlines the content of multimedia projects and how the content will be delivered in the classroom. So this allows you to properly deliver your content. Remember, the script you are writing carries content, and this content needs to be properly arranged in such a way that it will be delivered to students in a way that they will be able to learn the content. So it is usually the basic building block of multimedia development. Now, storyboarding is the graphical representation of the content to be presented in the multimedia project. And if you look at this, the key word here is the graphical representation. You will see this graphical representation. This is how a storyboard looks like, where you have where a text will be entered and the picture that will accompany the text. So basically, what you are doing here is that you are putting your text and the accompanying media elements that you are going to use to explain the text on a sheet of paper, so that you will know what exactly media content that will go with a particular content for multimedia production. And this is quite critical as script writing also. And the main difference is that a script can be written without visuals at all. In fact, a script is usually presented in text format, just text that will guide you in presenting your content to the students. Whereas a storyboard is always a visually illustrated script. Now, a script that has visuals, that has media components to explain the text, that's what we call the storyboard. Preparation for a multimedia script is a process of visual thinking or visualization. So, since you are just starting, you are projecting into the future to see what the multimedia project will look like. At this stage, you need to take note of what you put in your script and how you organize your storyboard. Now, let me leave you with this class activity one before we proceed. Now, welcome back. Let's quickly look at the stages in script writing. And the first stage in script writing is program idea. The program idea needs to be discussed. The question you ask yourself here is, why is it necessary to have multimedia?
at this particular for this particular idea? Why do I need to use multimedia to present this content? That is what, those are the questions you need to ask yourself at this stage of script writing. Then you have program brief. At this stage, you expand the program idea a bit to cover the title, the target audience. The target audience, that is the students, kind of students. You need to look at the characteristics of the students you want to teach, the objectives of the content, and the content outline, and some other things like that. That is the program brief. Then the third stage is the research, planning and carrying out a thorough research on the topic of the program idea and the target audience will be useful in designing the multimedia project. So you need to kind of carry out the research on the content. Then when you are carrying out a research on the content, then you look at the target audience. What are the characteristics of these students I'm going to teach? How they want to learn, their learning style, okay, their background, their technology skills, and some other things like that. Those are the things you need to take note when you are carrying out research at this point. Also, you need to identify and select content elements. Having done the research, it is appropriate to develop the best way or the sequence to deliver the message. The content is the most critical stage, is the most critical component of script writing. Because you are not writing script for movie, you are writing script to deliver instructional content in the class. So you need to identify and select the content elements. You need to identify, you need to select the interface design and layout. The interface design is one of the most creative stages of scripting. You take note of the look and feel of the program. How do you want to present this? What layout are you going to adopt? Are you going to prepare a PowerPoint and capture your screen while you're going through the PowerPoint? Or do you want to record your audio content? Then you impose the media as you narrate your story. This interface is very important because it will determine how the look and feel of your content will look like, especially when you are producing an instructional video. Then you need to prepare a storyboard. You can see here that storyboard is a critical component of script writing process. So storyboard is a subset of script writing. The storyboard is a detailed shot by shot or screen by screen description of the program on a page, maybe on a Microsoft Word or in a notepad, as I explained in the beginning. This is what we call the graphical representation of the content. And if you look at this picture, for instance, you see where you can put the media content, maybe the picture or the graphics, and the content in form of text that will go with this. So that you know that when you are reading this content that you have put here, there will be this picture accompanying the text here. So it serves as a kind of guide for you when you are producing a multimedia project. Now, the storyboard encourages the script writer to think in terms of multiple media use in a multimedia program. It is also a blueprint for action that can be given to a multimedia designer to execute as depicted in the storyboard. So if you have someone who will implement this for you, the script and the storyboard will be used by that person to implement the multimedia projects effectively and in such a way that it will reflect what you intend to present as a content to your students. So you need to take note of all this, you need to take note of all these stages and ensure that even though you may not have a formal script writing process when you are coming up with your multimedia projects sometimes, you need to put some things down. You need to write some things that will guide you, and you need to select appropriate media content by preparing storyboard and the content that will go with the media component. This will make multimedia production very easy for you, and it will have positive impact on the output of such multimedia production at the end of the day. Thank you for listening. I will see you in the next class.